Let's learn IIB. Today, we will create a project that uses Mapping Node for transformation. I'll be reusing an existing integration service project that I used to explain accessibility transformation in another YouTube video. See the description for accessibility YouTube link. To this existing project called node_features_v1, I'll be adding a new SOAP operation called mapping demo. Then I will add input and output arguments as shown on screen. Using the GUI, double click on the SOAP operation to create a subflow. When you double click on the SOAP operation, many changes occur in your project apart from creating the subflow. Your main flow, which contains SOAP input node, gets modified drastically. Add mapping node to your project as shown on screen. Double click on it to create a .map file. Now you have to provide input and output data structures to this .map file. I'll show you how to create data structure with multiple fields easily. If you have an XML file as shown on screen, use that and convert it into an XSD file. Right click on that XML and select Generate XSD. This toolkit utility helps you to create data structures easily. You can now include this new XSD in your WSTL schema. Next, for output structure, I have manually created 4 fields as shown on screen. Open .map file and link input to output structure. When you see a parent node with more than one occurrence in it, click and drag towards the output. This will create a for each loop. When you click and drag a node with only one occurrence, it will create a move mapping. Double click on the for each transformation. You will see the child nodes. You can individually drag and drop the child node from left to right, creating a mapping between them. Here you would have noticed that the transformation that we applied was using GUI. We have not written any code to map input to output. The tool has features to automatically do mapping for you. If the names match or they are an approximate match, then the tool will do the mapping for you. After this, save your files. Drag and drop your project to execution group. Bar file gets auto-generated and the project would be deployed. Use WSTL URL available in the properties of the deployed service. Use this URL in your SOAP UI tool to test the new SOAP operation. Copy and paste the input XML that we used to create XSD and then trigger the service. You should get output as shown on screen with 3 record elements. What have we learned today? The different concepts that we learned today are: 1. How to add a new SOAP operation to existing WSTL. 2. How to create an input message schema using XML file. 3. How to include that input schema in WSTL and the use of REF keyword, the reference keyword. 4. How to create message transformation using mapping node and without any coding in SQL. This was a short video that explained the use of mapping node. If you found the video to be useful, subscribe to my channel and share your feedback in the comment section. code is available in GitHub and some documentation is available in the blog post. Links in description. See you in the next video.